Let's face it, owning a home today sucks. 12 different accounts to pay your bills, trying to keep up with documents, filing insurance claims, it's all a big hassle. Grease fires, plumbing leaks, toilet overflows, this and that and that and this. We can all use a little bit of help. So what's your home plan? Sign up for home plan today and get a little bit of help managing your home. It's home management made simple. Sign up at joinhomeplan.com. Welcome back, connoisseurs, to the Cognac Corner, recorded in historic Soulard, Missouri. Go follow AFM on YouTube, Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter at Always Full Media. Some variation of that. Not now you want to work, now you're trying to figure it out. This is extraordinary conversation with ordinary people about love, sex, relationships, all fueled by cognac. cognac. I am Mr. Talk to Me Nice, Mr. Doing Too Much, Podcast Poppy, Podcast Daddy, Podcast Prophet, Podcast Visionary, Marcus Onesimus Boston. Welcome to the mob. Welcome to the mob. Welcome, 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 welcome. Where my gunshots at? Where my gunshots? Where my gunshots? With the Dracos. Here's the kids call it. They call sticks now. I said, okay, that's what we call.
I heard that. Sticks. I was like, what
they call
the?
Sticks now. I said, okay, well, okay. Well, so Draco's no longer cool.
Got it. They better with better than shooting. I'm like, that's still a gun. Okay.
Who volumes up while they watching the damn show? Who volume is that?
Maybe mine.
Probably. Look at that. Yeah.
So is that better?
And today
is that better?
We had That's excellent.
Thank you
so much. Today we have two new connoisseurs to Cognac Corner. First, we have Cherise. And we have Antonio.
What's going on, world? How y'all doing? Much love. Let's get this more dropping. Let's get this.
And we have an olive drop in the audience. Nicole's out here.
Going on looking
real Greekish. I see you look like a little Greek. Let's see, look Greek freak. Okay, the Greek freak out here. Olive Mediterranean shit out here. Balsamic sauce. Emo's house dressing.
That's her best friend.
Sweet little
bit. Look at her.
Oh man.
Got a tart.
I want to thank you guys for coming down to Cognac Corner. Today we're drinking Douce. Not because I wanted to pay for it, because all they had.
I mean, keep it real.
And I wasn't going to give y'all no Hennessy because I care for y'all too much.
Thank you.
Hennessy's for peasants.
I appreciate it.
Oh, whoa.
Regular Hennessy's for peasants.
Oh, wow.
Hennessy Black, Hennessy Blanco, Hennessy XO.
Hennessy,
the regular Hennessy is horrible.
It's for what?
You need either Douce, Ciroc Brandy.
What else you can drink?
That's about it. That's all I have over there. Regular Hennessy just, it hits too hard, man. This is the thing. Honesty without compassion is brutality. Honesty without...
Like, what's in the Douce? What is he drinking? Right. He turned to a poet.
To the content.
Out of 10 years, he ain't never been no damn poet. But now, honesty... Get out of here with that.
I read books now.
So this drink now.
When I got to cocaine at 30, I got into books and I've expanded my vocabulary.
Thank you.
And my use of words.
I appreciate it.
Yeah, you got to grow up. You know,
you have to.
What's the quote? Quote is, growing is optional, but progress is. No, that's not it.
I know you told me that last week.
Shit. That's my shit.
Up is black and white is red. No.
Okay, I'm gonna think of
no, he don't. No, Andre, sorry. It was brilliant. It's brilliant too.
But you didn't remember it though.
Because I used it a lot. I had a couple cocktails, so I'm a little spacey. It'll come back to me. I'll see it before it's over. So we're gonna open up things called throughout the show, little icebreaker called Straight Shots, No Chases.
All right.
Okay. So just a couple questions, get to know y'all and y'all, you know, long traveled lives with deal with opposite sex and all that stuff. Some more than others, but we're going to get to know each other. So the sound effect for this moment is called... Oh, I fucked that up. All right. Look, maybe the Wi-Fi is not going. Oh, wait, here we go.
Greetings and welcome. I want to play a game.
So straight shots on Chase, we do it. Yes, we do it.
Change my earphones. Wait. Okay, I'm ready. Sorry.
Ooh, boy. Straight shot, no chases. All right, here we go.
Let's do it.
If it weren't for a black woman, I wouldn't have cognac in my life. And I thank her every day. And she owns a bar, so I can thank her often by giving her my money. While clothed. Talk it. Okay, I'm sorry. Let me stop playing. What makes you lovable?
What makes me lovable? I have that nurturing.
Talk in this damn mic, please. There you go. You can put it in your hand. You can take it out and put it in your hand.
Okay.
What makes you comfortable? If you like to be hands-on with it, then do what makes you feel better. Yeah, there you go. Yeah. Woo! Focus, guys. Focus. Keep it together. That was telling me to focus. Becky can never. I'm just kidding.
I kind of got excited a little bit.
Kidding. Focus.
Calm down, brothers.
Breathe.
I'm trying to, Queen.
Oh boy.
What makes me lovable is I am very nurturing.
Mm-hmm. What's your sign?
Scorpio.
If I'm not mistaken, isn't Scorpio's like a fire sign?
No, it's a water sign. So get it.
Are you sure? Scorpio?
What do you mean? It's a horrible sign.
It's horrible.
A Scorpio is a water sign. Pisces. Let me and Google. Cancer.
Please
Google it.
Keep going.
Nicole, what's your sign?
Okay, I don't know what's bad about y'all, so you're fine.
So you had a bad experience.
Scorpio's a garbage.
Are you serious?
I've never had one.
So what do you mean? How can you speak on something you've never had? Because
you guys are horrible people.
What do you mean, horrible people?
I've had about 5 Scorpios in my life in different ways.
Okay, so.
Nothing romantically, I would never have sex with one. Okay. I like my life.
Okay.
I try to be like, RJ, I had to leave, but she was so good at leave. What? I got things to do in the morning. I can't be playing with you. Using sick days and shit because no damn reason.
So why do you think their Scorpios are horrible people if you've never dealt with them on that?
And when I say horrible, I'm being facetious when I say that. But I say
relationship
that
level.
Because the Scorpios only had like as friends and like business partners.
Okay.
Listening is never a strength.
What do you mean?
So they want to do what they want to do regardless of it making sense or not. And sometimes I don't need you to spray the whole room. Shoot them one time. No, you want to spray the whole room because you're so emotionally tied to what you want to do.
Exactly. I need you to put some. Listen, we are people. We are the sign.
You want to hold it and still not talking to it?
I'm talking into
you talking over, I'm, you, this you need me right here. Fuck right here. Whatever you do,
so
right here. So it
has to be directly in my face like this, right?
Put it below your mouth, but not.
Oh, right here.
Yeah,
is that cool?
Yeah, I mean, baby shots. Yeah. It's like mine is right in my right there.
Okay, thank you. All right.
See, look at that. Look at that.
I saw it.
I won't tell her what I know because this is what I do. Because
I got it. I did what you asked
thank
me
you.
To do.
Thank you so much.
With all the animation, I still did it. So, you never let me finish answering the first question. I didn't answer the first question. What makes me lovable? I'm lovable because I'm nurturing. I meet people where they are in life.
Yeah.
And I'm dope. What else you want to know?
And dope sells itself, baby.
There you go. I'm dope. So what else do you need to know? Thank you.
Holla, 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 holla. All right. She told you what she said.
She did?
She said what she said. So what makes you lovable, sir?
I don't think I am.
Damn.
Like, I try to be. No, uh-huh. I'm joking. What makes me lovable? I guess my heart, you know, kind of, it's welcoming to anybody. Like, I'll take you as who you are. Mm-hmm. Don't mean I'm going to hang out with you and everything, but I'll take you as
take me as I am. With Mary J. Fiel. Yeah.
There you go.
I know the song, too. I'm sitting around like, damn, I know the song.
Take me. He gonna as ask I me. I'm like,
you know what I'm saying? I'm like, so it was hot outside. No. As I say again, I take the person as they are, and in that instant, I can really, I guess, get a feel for my ass. I'm like, all right, you know what? You know, he's an asshole. I could, you know, connect with him because I'm assholes too. Don't even matter.
Is that direct towards me?
No. No, but in a way it is because
if the shoe fits, huh?
When I first met you, you were on the assholes. So I was more like, God, I like her.
Right.
I like this dude. Right, ooh, right. Her. I like him because he's cool.
Oh,
when I first met him.
Uh-oh.
Unless you got something to tell me. I mean, I'm cool with it.
No, we got nothing to tell you. He's an asshole. Yeah.
No. I like how she did that. The spin. But no. I guess I'm caring, you know. I'm like, I like to bring everybody under my umbrella no matter mm-hmm. what they are. So I try to, you know, do that, and I guess that's what makes me let's get it straight. I do love myself. Do love myself. Answer your question.
What makes me lovable? Mm-hmm. And there would have to be somebody that has loved me. You would need to ask them what made them love me. I know what makes me special.
Well, so the question should have been, you know. So the question should have been spent because I understand what he was saying. Everything is basically the same thing what you just said. It is literally but I guess he's just doing something else, but which is fine. So I get you what you're saying. Answer your question. Answer your question. Again, what makes me lovable? Because again, I give love, but I get it back. I ain't no simp. Right, I ain't no simp. Like, hey man, come with this drink. Yeah, this motherfucker would buy me a beer. Yeah, I hear him. Yeah. Yeah, he hear me too. Watch this. But like, I do my life. You see what I'm talking about, man? Yes. Nah, that shit don't happen.
Yeah.
In me. Don't happen. They usually, you know.
I sent for a woman back in my 20s for 3 years.
You did what?
You what?
I was a sent for a woman. I let her play me for 3 years. Sucker ass me.
True, but how old were you?
I was like 20.
Exactly. And that how old was a woman?
6. She probably was around the same age. She was Capricorn, too.
Same age?
Yeah, it was the same age. Our birthdays are not that far apart.
You must have had
I'm December Capricorn. She's January Capricorn.
I know a Capricorn.
Yeah.
She's cool, but yes, they are.
Yeah, I can never date a Capricorn. It's not going to work out.
It can. I'm a Taurus.
Oh, okay.
We link up like shower caps and, Ray, you know, Jerry Curls.
He nuts. Mm-hmm. You say you're a Taurus?
I am.
Nuts.
Is Scorpio the same ones, then?
Man, that's like the pot called a kettle green.
Right.
Green. It's black, but still.
Scorpios are not nuts. We don't act out unless we have a reason.
But y'all find a reason to act out.
No, we don't. No, we don't.
What's your most outrageous sexual encounter or place?
Ooh.
Outrageous?
Yeah.
I don't think it was outrageous. When I lived in California, it was on the beach. Venice Beach. It was.
That's what's up.
I'm with you. I was supposed to have some shit in Cancun, but she ruined it for us. So. She got Nathan.
I'm going to deal with that.
Yeah. You're going to talk to me nice, goddamn it. I don't care who paid for what. What you going to do?
All right. Is that question all?
Venice Beach.
Venice Beach. I get you. I'm probably with the same, you know, kind of not atmosphere, but the outsideness. Actually, had relations.
You had entanglement?
Oh, no. Not like that. No.
I love he just had relations.
Relation, I guess.
It was no entanglement.
Let me just be broad. Let me be blunt. So I was fucking this one girl.
Yeah. There we go. Yeah.
I'm like, damn. Yes. So, yeah. We actually had sex.
Yeah.
And everything.
Yeah.
Outside of a karaoke bar. And the funny thing was, I was
in a car?
Yeah. Oh yeah.
Who called? What kind of car was this?
I have a 2008 Chevy Equinox.
Oh, does the seats down in the back?
Yes, they do.
Yeah. Damn.
But it was in there.
So what kind of car was it?
It was in a, I want to say, Cobalt.
Something like that. Whoa! Yeah. What the?
Yeah, so I had to, you know.
Where in the Cobalt?
Right. Where back
seat,
in the Cobalt?
In the back seat. Back seat.
The back
seat. We pulled.
So y'all was like,
wow. No. I pulled the front seats up.
Okay.
They don't go that far up.
Was the windows tinted?
They were.
That's a hot-ass car, man. I had a Cobalt.
I give you that.
I had a Cobalt. I never would have thought of it. I wouldn't even think about it. God bless your heart, man. I'm glad you made it happen, man. Sometimes you just be on go mode. Like, we're going to make it work.
We're going to make this happen.
Man.
But no, it's funny because, again, it was at a karaoke bar, and I was up in like one or two.
So what was y'all singing that made her want to go outside and screw you?
My cherry pie.
Not what we singing, but
what were you drinking and what was the conversation?
How'd y'all get to that point? What was the lead up to this?
I just asked that.
It's a Friday. I was off on the weekend. Fresh cut, smelling good. Back has made it happen.
Ain't no one tell a nigga nothing with a fresh haircut.
And he's smelling good.
And he's smelling good. Oh, yeah. You better put some respect on my name.
What kind of cologne you have on? I'm going to tell you if you're smelling good or not.
Polo Black.
Yeah, you smell like
he's a dirty, dirty dog.
He's uh-huh. smelling pretty good with Polo Black up. He's pretty
smelling. Fucking love that. Mm. I'm like, yes. I can make it happen with this on this. Come here, girl. Come here.
What's your guilty sexual pleasure?
You answer first.
No, ladies first. You go left. You go around. Left. Around.
Stay on my left. I'm like,
is that clockwise? Oh, I'm confused. Wait. If you top the clock.
Wow.
Yeah,
so
clockwise.
Again.
Yeah.
I'm like, okay.
I'm 6:30.
Let me.
What's my guilt?
I mean, if I feel like, but my audience know enough about me. I'm here all the time.
Well, we don't know, so I'm gonna ask.
Right. Wait, you can ask me something if you want me to. Okay,
ask the question.
Hey, producer, hold me back, the director. Shit.
Hear me?
On the microphone, get that nigga something to say. Shit. No, I wouldn't even notice I wouldn't answer no question. You wouldn't have said nothing. Shit. I can't run nothing around here.
Mm. Yeah, you can't.
Go ahead, waiting on you. I'm last. So, what? See, my damn screen went dark.
So, can you...
What's your sexual guilty pleasure? Like, so what is the thing you like sexually the most? That's your shit.
I like Albert Einstein.
The fuck is that?
The fuck is that?
Ain't nobody putting no fucking piercing on their dicks, man. Who living like this? That's what you thought about?
You don't even get it, dude.
I don't. I'm sorry. I don't get out much. Okay, let me
Albert
drink.
Albert Einstein was very smart, which he had a brain.
He was saposexual? Is that what it's called? When you into the... Is that a saposexual?
No. Oh, my God. It went over your head. Really? So you don't understand what I mean?
Brain, brother. Head.
Thank you.
Oh, man. Why can't we
getting,
just...
Getting, see what's getting some...
I don't like this show no more.
Why?
I quit. Podcast Poppy retires. You shutting all this shit down. Take all this shit down. Right. Turn the lights off. Right. So all this shit is over.
Get a hose. Turn up.
I'm going back to my goddamn day job. Be quiet and happy.
Right.
Welcome to Staples.
Hey, welcome
Why
to Staples.
Is it Staples?
Can I interest you in a business chair?
Right.
Oh, God. Right.
This is CEO edition.
That's great. All right, Antonio, your turn.
Did you tag me in this?
I need to. I'm sorry. I'm good.
Antonio's guilty pleasure.
It. Why wouldn't you tag me in?
Because I'm flawed.
And we all are. I get it. Just don't let it happen again.
Wow.
Okay. This is the relationship that we have.
And I love it.
To me every day, he used to talk to me so reckless. And I would still be like, okay, what you doing?
Hey, friend.
But you know why? Because he was so, like, genuine. You know what I mean? I like genuine people. So that I didn't trip off of it. I know somebody else looked like, what is wrong with this bra? Letting this nigga talk to him like they didn't get out of a relationship. You know what I mean?
I'm here to do my time.
So I can get out of her.
That's it. No smoke. I am here to do my time. That's it. I'm walking with God. That's it.
There you go.
There you go.
One step at a time.
There you go.
What's my next question?
Tony will answer his first.
Oh, go ahead, man. I'm sorry. He wouldn't cut you off.
That's cool, you know.
I didn't make him nervous, you know what I mean?
Okay, there you
that
go.
Went to the last.
No one did that. That's not right. What you did.
Let's see. Guilty pleasure. What, jack off to porn? Wait, my master is porn? Like, I mean,
clutching my pearls. Clutching
my pearls, right? Like, you like, say...
Still masturbate to, of course, porn, but...
Can't have my jokes. You take my jokes, too?
Hey, but...
You want to share? I want to share, too, by now.
Right.
Been 20 minutes. It's my show. Hello, this is Tony Porn with us.
Right.
Welcome to the new Kanye Corner.
Right.
I am your host, Todd. You know, it's none of your business. Finn may be watching.
Mind your business. Right. Mind your business. Mind your business.
But to answer, like, finish the question. Not only do I watch, you know, for pleasure, learning, education, you know? Don't get it wrong. Some shit that is just like, no fucking way I'm going to try that on her. And she's going to be, that's so good. And she's going to be like, get the fuck off me, stop.
Okay. Okay, look. So other than something new that you can learn from a porn, why would you even watch it? Because everything else you should know already. It's like a mind thing. If you enjoy yourself or your person that you're going to come up with all kind of stuff to do.
Yeah, you just answered your question. Like, if I love myself, which I did, I loved myself.
Right. But I'm saying, you say you look at it for, like,
so not only in the world, say, when I do watch it and everything, you know, of course, I'm just watching everything. But sometimes, like, wait, hold up, maybe that, you know what, let me, this weekend, I'm gonna try that.
Oh, okay.
And see what happens. See,
okay.
Like, oh, you know what, putting her on my leg, I think that would be better than, you know, jumping off a chair. Dick hard,
that,
you know what I'm saying?
That
Geronimo!
That would end terribly.
Exactly, exactly. Okay. So that's why I think, like, yeah, some
so
shit.
So you get some ideas.
That's it.
Oh, okay.
And, I mean, you're supposed to.
Do you?
For men? Oh, yeah. I mean, we're doing the work.
So some, not all the time.
Unless you get a lazy motherfucker, and otherwise, we doing the work. We doing the work.
Okay.
I mean, not trying to get off course, like, let me ask you. Yeah, what is your favorite position?
He stole the question.
I just want to say I didn't want to say your time from you.
You know, go ahead.
No. But I was going to try to prove a point.
Right.
Okay, know. You can say you're on top. How long are you going to stay on top?
Think about them knees now. Yeah, you may look 30, but them knees ain't. The knees are the knees.
Right, the knees.
Let me have the knees.
I got a life.
Right.
That's not the thing. Even some good knees are.
I'm just saying that.
Because
right.
Some guy can get.
You're coming because of something that you're doing. You're coming because of something I'm doing.
Oh, man. Of course. So, of course. I'll give you that. Right, but most do, even
time,
though they.
Times, you can't say how long does it take to make you come? That's the question. How long does it take?
Well, if that's the case, it'd be a two-parter. Cause
did you tag me? You can tag me.
I did.
I didn't see it. I don't see it.
Yeah, I think.
It really is. No, but in a way, but you're still watching. Not too much mental, because if you just watching,
refresh
like,
your
she should already, if you already doing it, you should already be, well, never mind. You're right, because you may have one of those.
Right.
Like, damn, right. Man, I just want to get right. One off, but I don't want to hit her.
Yeah,
yep,
let yep. It go. Leave it alone.
Yep, see?
Yeah, I know.
Okay.
Maybe I should have had a.
You have my chair because clearly y'all need me here. I'm just drunk. You mind my business. When y'all done, I push the stop button.
I'm just staff. You don't need me.
And cut.
I bring nothing to conversation no more. Hold on, pass this on to somebody else. I ain't fucked in years. What do I know about here? I'm telling lies. I'm not living out here. Never mind. Keep going. Next question.
And you're lying.
Last time I had a woman was November 2019. What's that?
Wait. I'm sorry.
Why are you lying?
I've been working. I've been chilling, man. I've been really focused.
And you have not been that focused.
I have.
Really?
Since,
lying.
Since she stuck with that wedding that night.
Wow.
I've been felt the type of way. So I'm gonna pour my soul into my craft. Window shop. I don't buy shit. I'm going to bed. I said window shop. I still make sure my jumper wet. I still make sure I'm still desired. I ain't finna buy shit. I just be the window shop. Ghost.
So you never five finger.
I'm a Pornhub premium daily member.
I can't believe you.
I
guys
pay my
$11
a month. Shit, I got a whole playlist. I got where my mood is. I got shit. I got my favorites.
So you got one according to your mood.
Hell yeah.
Are you serious?
I like production. So I need a scene. I like to feel like I'm watching people live their life. I don't want to walk into and say, fuck, this is an actual porn. Like, oh, okay. Timmy?
The casting couch.
Oh, you going to fuck her to keep from kicking your son's ass? What you go? How much you love your son? I say, yes! I need a nice condo. I need to believe I'm watching some shit. Okay. I'm going to be watching. I need production. I need 1080p. I need my fucking script. I need at least 30 minutes. I'm going to fast forward to certain parts, but I need at least the whole thing should be 30 minutes.
Oh, okay.
So, get here, guys?
You know what? I don't even watch porn.
She hurt my feelings, and I haven't been vulnerable since.
With the girl
I blame
did.
Her. Yeah, the one with the cat, dog, and kids. When she left me, she
and
left
no
me.
Air.
And no fan,
no circulation.
Fan. None.
You should have definitely never
fucked
that lady with the no fan and no air.
I should have known. I believed in her. I believed in her, did.
So she made you give up all your faith in
everyone? No, I just like, I'm going to fall in love with my craft. I'm going to do this podcast thing. I really fall in love with it because these streets don't deserve
me. I'm going to be with you.
Chris Brown. Okay, we gotta get back on track, guys. What was your question? Did you say?
Wow.
I don't know either. Anywho, I think my most outrageous sexual encounter would be damn. Would have said Cancun. Would have said Jamaica. They didn't act right. I had a good time in Jamaica and Cancun. I think my favorite time was when I went out of town with somebody else's wife on a work trip.
What?
work trip.
Yeah, so
work
she, trip. I went with her to her conference somewhere, and I was just hanging out doing shit. She, you know, I was like, she went on the phone talking to her husband, like, it was great.
So all you, on the balcony you, and shit. You happy to be a side, Nick?
I'm a great one. I know my position.
Oh, you do?
Hell yeah. I've had like 4 or 5 wives in my day.
Yeah.
Back in my 20s when I was outside. Yeah, like my women grown. I don't got time for these fucking kids. I want to be the kid relationship. I want to be the
bro.
I want to fill. I want to fill all the gaps in your life. Where the gaps at? I got it. Right there. That's it. This is a nice guy. I'm going to give you hope. I'm not destination. I'm a step in the right direction. So I'm not here to stay. I'm here to get you to the level back. We back out here confident and better for somebody else. I don't deserve you, but I want to get you prepared to go in the right direction to find the love you deserve.
Like, but she's already married though.
Right, that's cool.
Evidently, she's
not happy. She's not happy.
Yeah, she's missing something in there.
She called me. I didn't call her. I said, I'm available. I ain't doing nothing. I got a little time. What you got? You want a Marriott Star? You want River City? You want a Ritz Carlton? What you want to do? I got some sick time. Tell her answer. That shit'd be great, huh? Well, all right, gotta go in the morning. Cool. What time to check out? Noon.
What,
I'm gonna
what
be
you
here
about
noon.
To do? Huh? What you about to do?
You gotta work. You gotta work in the morning. All right. Well, bye. I'm gonna go back to sleep till noon. Check out. Fuck out of here. Hell yeah. Yeah.
Maybe, I don't know. I can't.
I'm a step in the right direction. I'm not destination yet.
Yeah, no
in between.
Yeah.
I'm a Mr. In Between. I'm gonna add that to my name too. Mr. In Between.
So you ever dated a married woman?
I'm a bridge, Antonio. I'm a bridge between two places.
Have you ever dated a married woman?
Like, I have, but both of us were separated.
They were still married, though.
Yes, but this wasn't like. Yeah,
no. So they were in different different addresses and stuff like that? They were,
yes.
Okay. So how did it turn out?
Well,
I mean,
I want to see what I'm still talking to. But not like that.
I need a ride.
I cannot stand him.
I bet
you. Waffle House in the morning, baby. Hey, I love Waffle House. That's one of my favorite breakfast. I love Waffle House.
Hell yeah.
I do.
Sorry. Let's go. Wait, did you even ask me a question? She asked me a question.
I did.
Somebody asked
I have talked to two of them. They were married, but they were separate.
Okay.
Separated. Now, one I don't talk to at all.
Mm-hmm.
One I do talk to, but nothing like of that serious nature. Just,
hey, how you doing? Yeah. How you been doing? How everything?
Yeah.
How the kids and shit like that, right?
Something like that.
Oh, okay.
Now, there is possibilities.
Like, of what?
Like last week. She may have came over and everything, but it's been a while.
They don't want to see me out here fucking again. Cause I was, man, if I do all this and start fucking, we might be millionaires by the end of the year. Okay.
So you selling yourself?
No, I'm not. But next question. if you can know one thing about your future, what would it be?
Ooh.
All right, whoever
go first. Honestly, what would it be? Oh, man, me personally. Am I happy?
Mm. Yes.
Like, seriously. Like, yes. Am I, like, in the same, you know, not saying I am now, but, like, am I in the same funk I was in, or am I still, I'm rich now, am I, you know, wealthy? You know, I don't want to be rich, I want to be wealthy.
Right.
To the point where, like, great-great-grandkids,
blowing, I can't blow this in a weekend, you know, in Vegas. Yeah.
But yeah, I want to know if I'm happy, you know, like, all right, you know, happy as in mentally.
Yeah.
Because you can have a wife and, you know, of course be miserable and everything. So yeah, that would be me.
Well, go ahead, I just, shit. Right. It's a good thing to be.
I had a Miss Producer.
What'd she say?
Miss Producer.
That is a good one.
I had that, his answer was good. What we talking about good?
The answer.
Answer's great.
Reply. I ain't talking about you.
Nobody ever talk about me. I make things to talk about me, and no one still will talk about me. What's your answer?
I would say being fulfilled. Fulfilled. That's a little bit of everything. I think, like, happiness. Everything is being fulfilled. I think if you're fulfilled, then you're happy, right? Do you think so? I
think it's insane.
What the hell does that mean?
What?
Fulfilled? Like, you mean fulfilled in all areas of, fulfillment.
Yes, of fulfillment. So just
it's,
like,
it's almost like saying,
you feel like life well lived.
Yes. Like, like life well lived.
My answer is, how many lives do I impact? Like, how many people do I impact in my life? It could be high level impact, it could be low level, but like, how many lives do I touch?
You won't know until you die.
I'm saying, but that's
until if I can to
know,
funeral.
Well, that's the question. If I can know one thing about my future, I won't know how many people impact.
But you had to die first.
Well, I gotta die. Why can't people just tell me I can't just tell? I can say I impacted his life. Why gotta be dead?
That's when everybody come out that you never even knew.
You my flowers now. Don't waste the motherfucking on
care of me. People don't give you the flowers now. They wait till you die. Then everybody come out.
RJ gave me some flowers. Shit. RJ gave me some flowers while I'm here. God damn. RJ, old white girl fucking ass. He gave some flowers.
Don't talk about RJ. He not here now.
I call RJ. He probably was some white woman at his house in Lime.
Oh, what?
Let me quick go for RJ. I love RJ. RJ my guy. RJ my bro. My bro. Drunk sex or high sex?
Ooh.
What you prefer? Drunk sex or high sex?
Ooh. Probably drunk sex.
Any freak nasties in this room? Oh, shit.
Probably drunk sex.
That can be the same thing, too. Like they, you can.
It
can
be
like,
both, but I don't know.
Damn, Miss Producer. Say it again. Yes.
I like drunk.
Drunk sex.
I guess not too drunk because you know what's going on. You know. Oh, I'm just saying.
Also called,
You know the best time I always had, so she take her kids to her dad's house and you take her out and she ain't been out in a while and you treat her like a woman, not mom or a professor. Man, get back to that house. I said, look at God. Won't he do it? Yes, he will.
You were not supposed to be putting
God. Go out, have some dinner. Have some drinks, have good no conversation, you know, all the stuff, all the cute, cuddly stuff. And then you see one of your exes there, and they see her, they see him, and she's like, oh, yeah, and she's going to show out. Like, oh, well, now she mad, she finna show out because she mad. So, oh, this will be extra nasty tonight. Grab her some more drinks, get back to the house.
No.
You watch some Netflix, you cooking breakfast. Oh, some food before it go down.
Need that nourishment, you know what I'm saying? Need that nourishment. You're about to pull an all-nighter.
I'm going to say, no, I'm grab my fan and my bag out of my trunk. Let me grab my bag out. I'll see what kind of nice it's going to be.
Like, babe, I'll be right back. I'll be right back.
Yes. All up in the driveway. And she smoked, too. I was like, yes. We smoked all in the house. Anywho, next question. Sorry.
Let's see my answer.
Oh, I'm saying, sorry. Yeah, thank you. Go ahead, bro.
Drunk or hot?
Drunk or high?
What?
High? Oh, high. I think you said hot.
Drunk or high? Drunk sex or high sex?
Hot. H-O-T. Right. Oh, high. H-O. High. Oh, yeah. Drunk sex. Yeah.
H-I-G-H.
Perhaps. Perhaps. No. That's what I'm saying. Right? Like, is it high or hot? You're asking. High. Oh, high. Drunk. Definitely drunk. It's funny because I think I lose, like, I don't find myself, you know what I'm saying, high. Drunk, I still got control. Like, yeah.
Let's take care of business.
Darkwing Duck style.
I got dark, didn't it?
Yeah.
Let's take care of business.
Darkwing Duck.
Freaky man.
But when I'm like, it's, I don't feel like, you know, I'm like doing anything. I'm just there. Like,
I think I like when I'm drunk, I use my high to bring me back to a functional level. I think it balanced me out. It also depends on what we're doing. We're moving around, you know, like, la, 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 la. I don't know. Anywho. This went off the rails.
You sure real fast. Did.
Would you rather have a virgin or a porn star?
I want to say porn star.
I want a professional.
I want to say porn star. You? I can't have.
Do you want to use the stick or no?
No.
That's okay.
That's fine right here. Just chill out.
Okay, where do you answer, ma'am?
You say what now? I didn't hear.
Would you rather be with a porn star or a virgin?
A virgin? Yes, I wouldn't want to be with a porn star.
Would you let a virgin fix your car? You go to the mechanic, right? Professional?
Oh, it's different.
Or a plumber?
That's different.
No, it ain't.
Yes, it is.
That's a whole lot. No, it's not. I want a professional. I want somebody that knows what they're doing.
Yeah, when it comes to my car, yeah.
And my dick. What? I want a professional. I want somebody to get some miles on it and know what they're doing when they get there. I'm going to figure some shit out on me. I ain't got time figuring out. I need to hit the ground running. I need a veteran. I don't know, goddamn rookie. I want you to know. I need to know the language, try to run the playbook, all that shit. I got time. Time is precious.
Well, I don't know.
But most guys say porn stars. Most women say virgins. So it's almost. A couple women that said porn stars. I was like, yeah, I can see that. I trust her too. She a real one. Right. She about that life. I respect her.
Real.
Yeah, she about that life. How many of your friends have you been with that you're still friends with?
What do you mean? Like,
how many of my friends? I think none of my friends I hang out with, I've been with.
I don't hang out with them, but we're still friends.
Okay, so how many?
About two.
That's not bad.
Oh, shit.
Let me get my calculator. I didn't bring a notebook.
We're still friends and everything. Goddamn.
Goddamn, ho, come on. Oh, man. All right.
Let's just say, I say four.
Oh, that's a reasonable number.
Let's say four.
That's not bad.
Let's say four. Right.
How many are you still friends with?
All things you emotion.
Okay.
H-Town. So that's a hidden gem.
I know.
Emotions make you cry sometimes.
Wow. That singing make you cry sometimes.
Fall in love. All right. Question was, me now? Now none. All those friends, I'm not friends with them more. But it was a moment when I was really in my peak of my snowman days. Snowman. Probably 6-7. Like if I'm hanging around a bunch of women and we friends, you could probably say at some point I didn't knock one down. All of them. It's just what it is. Like we cool. We still hanging out doing shit. Deal, right? Yeah, but it was moments where. Don't ask no questions, man. You don't like this life, but I was outside. I was in my 20s. I was outside. Mm-hmm. Outside, inside.
I cannot.
I'd rather be with you. Here you go. How did you get caught cheating? And how did you get caught cheating? Wait.
Huh?
How'd you catch your spouse cheating? How did you get caught cheating? If you cheated. I probably worded it very complicated. So have you been cheated on first?
Yes.
And how'd you catch them?
Okay.
Then how'd you get caught cheating? Okay. I'm assuming I ain't shit and got cheated too.
No. I caught my ex. Well, this was like a long, I mean like.
Yeah, I say you put a lot of loans on
everything. Yeah, it is.
It's in the 80s?
No, early 90s.
Okay, that's not long.
Okay, right. Well, that's when I came back to St. Louis. So it was like early 90s or something like that. So I went to his house, and I was always...
Did you page him first?
No, because I was able to just go, just drop by. You know what I'm saying? Just come. If he knew I was coming that day, it doesn't matter what time I got there. Mm-hmm. So what happened was when I got there, his room was like in the basement. So I go in the basement. It's dark. I cut the light on. He was in the bed with his baby mama. Naked. Bucky Nicky.
They was talking about the kids. They wasn't doing shit about the kids.
Yeah, right. Whatever.
They was talking about the kids.
Whatever.
That was a time in my late 20s. I wanted to have baby mama. I was thinking, oh, if you got baby mama, you always go back and fuck your baby mama. Like, you always go back and fuck your baby mama. Especially if you're a good dad, like, you can always go back and knock your baby mama off. It's just like, that's selfish.
No. I don't do that. Come back that back and forth stuff. I don't do
right,
that.
Right. But I would never be a bad baby daddy. So when we break up, we still gonna be cool.
You can be cool, but you ain't got to be in my bed, though. We can be cool.
We can go to a neutral space. We got to go eat something. We got some neutral. Be adults and be like, love you. Hey, we great mothers and dads. We can't be together, but this works. Every once in a while, it's all the time.
No.
In between dicks, you want to throw in there? In between jobs, some shit. I'm right here. I'm a freaking gangster, you know
what I'm saying? So you like being a side dude.
I don't like complications. I like to be simple things.
Okay.
That's all I like.
Well, that makes sense.
I like clarity and simplicity.
Yeah, okay. All right.
I like that. I always like that word, simplicity.
Simplicity.
I like that.
What do you prefer?
Self-explanatory.
Yes. So did everybody answer the question before I move on?
I didn't ask the second part. How I got caught cheating was when I was younger, and I lived in California, and I was talking to the opposite gangs, right? Mm-hmm. So one of the other gang members came to my house. Mm-hmm. It didn't go down
what,
like
what
this.
What in the snowfall going on right now? What in the Franklin Saint?
Juice. Snowfall's
fucking great.
I love Franklin. I love me some Franklin Saint. But that's what happened. Mm-hmm. That's what happened. That's the only, because I don't cheat.
Wait, I'm confused with the gangster story. So, your gangster caught you at the house of another gangster?
No, I was at home.
So, you had two gangsters?
And one gangster was at my house already. Uh-huh, uh-huh. And then the other gangster just so happened to come over.
Uh-huh.
So, it was the opposite
So he was hitting. He was
I wasn't having sex then, so I wasn't. You know.
Yeah, I was just hanging out.
That was it.
Just hanging out with gangsters. Gangsters do gangster shit.
Yeah. And that's it. Because other than that, no, I don't cheat. So.
White liquor, dark liquor.
Dark liquor. But he didn't answer the other question.
I'm sorry. Your cheating stories. You cheating motherfucker. You. Sorry. That was aggressive.
Yeah, it really was.
Sorry, I apologize. I'm in 3 really was. Go ahead.
I can go.
I ain't no hostage, man.
Where is the bathroom?
Right across
the hallway.
Right here?
Mm-hmm. I just cleaned that toilet, too. Clean now.
Oh, shit.
And I bought the wrong size toilet seat. I supposed to bought the elongated. I bought the regular.
Right.
Just a little gap. It's all right.
That's all. I don't think I ever cheated. If I did, never got caught. But did I catch? She didn't cheat on me. Well, we weren't together. She was just fucking with another dude. Mm-hmm. And I thought I was, you know what I'm saying? It was just me. I was being stupidly, ridiculously adolescent, like, uh-huh. I think, no, bro, no.
Nah,
bro. It's not
me,
right.
And,
so, no. I just gone like, oh, okay. All right, kind of like a call, and she was picking up, so I called again from another number. I did the right thing, but I waited.
Huh? It's a lot of work.
Not for real, because I called twice from my cell phone. Uh-huh. One answer, then, like, I waited, like, I want to say like 17 minutes, called from another number.
Not 17.
Yeah. Well, I don't want to do it, you know. Right. Yeah. You can't be like obvious.
Oh, okay.
You know, you can't be obvious.
You've done this too before. You've been through this? Whatever he's committed. Whatever we're talking about, you sound very familiar.
I just cannot answer the other end.
Ah. Oh, wow. This is beyond fascinating.
Yeah, well, she picked up her to do number. Her to do. I'm like, okay. All right. I know where I'm at. Mm-hmm. Hung up. Haven't talked to her since.
That's the cold game. I mean, but
cold world, boy.
I mean, I was a fool so much where I made this girl a mix CD back in my mix CD making days. Wow. Drove her to her house, saw this nigga caught in the driveway and knew what was going on. And put the motherfucker in the mailbox and Drake and drive my ass home. I said, I never again.
You put the CD in the mailbox?
And she was getting piped down in a very nice king size bed that I was familiar with. I said, I know what's going on in there. Okay. I know what goes on in Katie's house. I've been there. I know exactly what's going on. I should not do it, but I had a heart. I didn't have it in me. I just put the motherfucker in the mailbox and walked back.
You don't know me by now. You will never.
All the nuts.
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't know that.
He ate all the nuts.
You know.
I
don't
know
if
that's for the table, but
it was a small amount. I did for myself.
But it was for the table, right?
It was not for the table.
That's what I was asking. Was it for just for you?
Or oh, just for, yeah, I was going to say, it was just for me.
Okay.
Yeah. Oh,
okay.
No, you I apologize. I should have been gentleman.
Then you should have offered.
Yes. Mm. That's my fault.
So go get some.
I will not. Okay. I will not, but,
just,
you know.
I just said.
I know you had your shot. I feel you.
Condoms and Plan Bs.
Ooh, what?
Ooh, both.
What do you say?
Condoms or Plan B?
Oh, condoms.
Both. Because sometimes you slip up. But condoms you can't feel none.
Yeah, wait for my answer. Yeah.
Yes, as well as the producer. I mean.
Well,
the producer has been giving us 2 cents all night long to the early moment. She won't quit. And might as well. Let's hear the story. Matter of fact, before we get to the host, our gracious host,
yes,
let's hear from our gracious producer,
our EP.
Yes. No, thank you. What was
the question was, beautiful. Condoms or Plan Bs, producer?
I'll say PS. I'll say PS.
Oh. Emotion make you cry sometimes.
I'm gonna just say.
Oh man. So Plan B. No, I'm joking. I'm joking.
I'm having a hard time with this microphone. I hope you get together soon.
The producer just didn't want to sound.
She got tired of helping that motherfucker. Like, I'm tired of this motherfucker. This motherfucker heavy. Got some weight on this. Motherfucker got some weight on this motherfucker.
Where would
you thought it was? These knees. Yeah, all right.
I was tired of holding this. No, this big, like, right.
This buddy.
I was like, I'm tired.
Improved your point, buddy. Improved your point.
Right. Let me do something different. Right. Back to the stand.
All right. Let me scoot this tray up some more.
All right. Shit. I can't do it. Can't do it anymore.
Me personally, I like to mostly deal with women that have had hysterectomies. At that point in life, war is over. Yeah, that's a great answer. Round of applause.
Not Apollonia 7. And they say she was a sex fiend. They say she was a sex fiend. I'm like, come on, bitch. When I saw little Nicky grind. Yeah,
that's my favorite movie. I have a 25th anniversary edition upstairs.
Yes.
Anywho, back to the oldest person, the youngest person being with, age wise.
You talking about like now or period?
Period. Damn.
Right.
Oh, shit. Sometimes it's hard sometimes. But he comes next to dollars. I gotta feed these kids.
Let's see.
That van has stopped by the house once or twice. That nigga in them socks and sandals and stopped by.
Like, come here, boy.
The real sock. That's the real thing.
Come here, boy. Let me talk to you.
Now they got some blue pills. Like, oh, shit. This nigga ready.
Hey, boy, reach around there and give me that drink.
Right.
Come here, boy. Reach around.
All right, what's your ages, man?
Ages. The oldest I had, I will say, 52, 53. Mm-hmm. Youngest, 23. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. I know, I wasn't proud of that.
How was you? She was 23.
Recently.
Oh, you should be shaming yourself.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah.
Hold on a second.
I shouldn't ask you a follow-up question. I'm sorry.
Let's drop your mouth.
Did you plug that that white charge into the thing?
There you go. So yeah, I was gonna say recently, not like a couple of days ago, but recently, like in the past year and a half, something like that. So
you was fucking through COVID?
Right.
Who fucked during COVID? Raise your hand. You motherfucking heathens.
I know.
You dirty mother.
I'm just hating. I didn't.
Because your shit was dry. Like, hold on a second, baby. Hold on. Let me be great.
Who are you talking about? Him or me?
Oh,
he's talking about him. Oh, he's talking about you.
I wouldn't do like that.
Okay. I just want
like,
to
I know you, but then I don't know you. Exactly. If he would have said that, I would like.
They know each other.
Black love.
You like? Yeah, they know each other.
Not yet.
I'm just hating.
What other question?
About them kinds of Plan B's. Yeah, I know. I know what it was. I know what it is. What you got over here? Nothing? Okay. What's your answer? What's your youngest or oldest?
The oldest is 61.
Oh, shit.
Mm-hmm. But you gotta say, like, I wouldn't say the oldest. Say, like, how many years older than you have. It's like, now I wouldn't say I
bet. Oh, no, not now. This was, like, maybe this was some years ago.
Yeah, yeah. So, okay. Yeah. Yeah.
And then the youngest, I was 28. Uh-huh. And he was 19.
God damn. I'm playing with Chingy and shit. Okay. Chingy Lane. 28, 19. What are you? Okay, I get it. That makes more sense. What were y'all talking about? What was it? You not let him talk? You just. He, oh, okay. Yeah. Straightening. That's you right. You right.
That
you
was
right.
Still in my early, late, with well, my late 30s. I mean, my late 20s. Right. My late 20s. So that was the last. That was that. But at first, I didn't know how his age.
Yeah, 19-year-old guy is different than 19-year-old
girl. He looked older because he had like a whole beard. I mean, he looked like. He didn't look 19.
But y'all never went to a bar or nothing, had drinks?
In my house, yeah.
Well, he couldn't go out because he was 18, right? Mm-hmm.
19. But
yeah. So you supplying minors?
I wasn't supplying nothing.
Sensation limitation?
He was bringing the liquor with him.
How did he get the liquor?
I don't know. I wasn't there. I wasn't there.
He showed up ready. And I didn't ask no questions.
Yeah, he showed up and showed out.
I think my oldest was 54. Hey man, I told you what I've been to, bro. I'm like, this boy. Shit, her husband had a nice house too. It was beautiful estate.
Wow.
And she was married.
Yeah.
I thought that too. So he said, yeah, her husband. Like,
yeah. Oh, wow. I had to share her with her husband. I thought it was pretty reasonable. I think it was pretty reasonable. It was fair.
Like, man, our wife is doing her thing.
Like, she's growing, my guy. She's like, growing, bro. Like, high five. Teamwork.
No.
I think the youngest was 19, but I was like 21, so don't really
care. Oh, well, that wasn't that young.
I've always shot older. I hated kids when I was a kid, so I don't like people my age.
You like older women.
I like people that, I like adults because I don't like to be one. Yeah, because I want to be the reckless one. Because my reckless is not that bad. So like, okay. Yeah, I need leadership.
Right.
My mom is 55. Her husband's 20. Ooh, I'm gonna say 28.
Ooh.
38. I get so much better. They've been married 14 years.
Really? Mm-hmm. That's pretty good. That's really good.
Yeah. They've been married 14 years.
That is really good.
So he graduated 01. I graduated 03. So that's about the math. Yeah, he might be a Scorpio too. He November something.
It matters what November something is.
Yeah, I don't care that much to remember.
Okay, well, don't worry.
Yeah.
What is
your sign? I'm a Capricorn.
He's a nut.
I am his? I don't know.
No, you.
I'm a Capricorn, December 23rd. December
2-3. I used to date a Capricorn's birthday was December 22nd. He's deceased now, but. I mean, Christmas. Huh? Tyrese.
Yeah. He might be a January Capricorn. January I'm Capricorns are different.
Come on, for her nice thought.
These are the signs of love making.
It's about to get
managed. Right.
He said he managed.
I don't want to go back down that road, man. That petrifies me part of my life. I don't ever want to find out. I don't ever want to be free. I don't want to keep that under wraps.
No,
I don't want to keep it under wraps. Cuddle monster, a bitch, get off me.
Cuddle monster.
Same.
I'm King Cuddle out here. I say this one time on the previous show, back when I had some options. And I was like, I fucked the cuddle. And I was being facetious. That took me serious. I'm like, hey, I might come over here actually just to hang out. But like, at least think I might fuck today. I'm not. I wish at least like, be prepared. Like, he might. Nope, I'm not. I'm trying to get something to eat, smoke, and go sleep.
And cuddle.
Very nice bed.
And cuddle, right.
And cuddle, for real. Right. Nothing's going to happen. But we know it was. I'm gonna be honest with y'all. I shouldn't tell nobody this.
This but is between you us. This is between us. Okay. Between don't us. Tell nobody else.
I like SUVs. She lost a lot of weight. And I was like, it's just not gonna work for me. I didn't want to say it, but that's why.
So you like bigger women.
When she was like,
what's the SUV first?
Sport utility vehicles, sport utility vagina.
Big girl.
Go big girl, what you gonna do? But you gotta be confident in what you are. But I know what I am. I know what I'm into. And then I'm not against it, but
no, bigger women, like, is that what you mean? SUV? Or
I might go there first. I'm not only into that, but like, I like women are comfortable in their skin. Okay. So confidence is always an important thing.
Right, me. Right. Yes. Okay.
And so once she got to this new shit, I was like, you don't feel confident in this body you in now.
So she lost weight.
Yeah. And she cheated. She got the surgery. I was like, I get it. It's fair. But like, you didn't lose it like you were going to the gym.
Right, you ain't got
that shit because you got extra thousands of dollars to get it done. She had a big ass house and like, what the fuck? O'Fallon and shit. Great person. But I was like, this is not going to work. And it didn't work. I was like,
give it real.
And she didn't talk to me nice either. You're not going to talk to me nice and not really be fluffy like I like. You got to, you want Pacifica. I want a Pacifica. I want a fucking Tahoe. Wow. I want a Ford Escape. I want a fucking real SUV.
We want a big body girl. Big body
I want you to be nice. Talk to me nice when you get there on time.
Oh, Lord. Oh.
It's crazy that he
says
a lot that I noticed that he
says
a lot.
Talk to me nice. Talk to me nice. Or he
gives.
He said more.
I'm talking to you, baby. They're not talking to you,
now. I don't respond with. I have PTSD.
You got something. I don't know if it's PTSD.
My mom used
to
yell at me all the time, so like I don't respond with. I'm like, talk to me nice. Because she be yelling. I'm like, why are you yelling at me today? You did nothing. I don't respond well to yelling. I'm like, talk to me nice, please.
He's crazy. So, he's a nutbag. He's a nutbag.
Yeah. All right, here we go. Music doing sex or silence?
Silence.
Ew.
Silence!
Absolutely not.
But you know what? You saying silence, but if it's silence.
I got a whole playlist.
I'm doing a whole playlist.
I like it. Silence.
In my whole bag, I bring a mini speaker.
Right.
I got a playlist. Cognac Corner vibes. No. I press play. No. Press shuffle.
I be listening too much to the music.
Nah, the music will make him perform better.
That's the case, and he's not taking care of business.
That's not true.
Then why are you focusing on music if he?
No, I'm just saying that's just me.
Gotcha.
Like, everybody's not the same. Right, and I like it silent because I don't know. I just like to. No. I'm saying music wise, I don't need the music, but the talking and the growl. I like to hear that, and I don't.
Hey, that's the cut for real.
I can't stand him.
She lost her. Oh, yeah. Two pages.
I can't stand him.
Shoot. Isn't that Mr. Edmonds? Hear me?
This is Babyface.
Mr. Edmonds! Right. Oh, I'm sorry. You're right.
All right.
No.
All
right, tween. Oh, yeah.
I'm long strokes with this.
Yeah, Kenna.
Let's face it. Owning a home today sucks. 12 different accounts to pay your bills, trying to keep up with documents, filing insurance claims. It's all a big hassle. Grease fires, plumbing leaks, toilet overflows, this and that and that and this. We can all use a little bit of help. So what's your home plan? Sign up for home plan today and get a little bit of help managing your home. It's home management made simple. Sign up at joinhomeplan.com.
Kenneth
Edmonds.
Whip a peel on that ass. Yeah. That's long strokes. You gotta have music, the soundtrack to a good movie.
Or this is for the cooling.
This is for the cooling you. Ooh,
you can lay you long strokes to that too.
Ooh.
This is for the cool.
Cooling you. I'm going to join that. Let me hit this one more time. Get back to this. Back to this love.
You trying to say that? Hey. You know, nobody can do this to you?
Hey.
In this tempo?
Hey.
Yo.
Hey.
Every move we make can
help. You
no, no, then he not, then he that is not too fast. That is
no, see, that this, is see, not this, it.
This is like a I'm sorry. Oh, she can't. Girl, I'm in a long time coming.
I can't hear none of this.
And girl, every time I close my eyes, I think about.
Okay, we got focus. Okay, we get back to this.
Thank you.
Please,
focus.
Okay.
Wow.
All right, we're rapid fire. Okay. Shit.
Bang, bang.
Hey, okay, here we go.
Hungry.
Hey, number 845. Relax. We got a whole night ahead of us.
No, we don't. I have something to do in the morning.
Oh, okay. I'm sorry.
I gotta work.
Oh, okay. I'm sorry. I apologize. Okay.
I know she's a little, like, a little rough. I do too, but I was like,
All right. You like whispering?
I know I'm messing with you. Like love?
Dirty talk doing sex.
Yeah, I like it.
I'm not good at it.
What's that?
Dirty talk doing sex. I gotta really be drunk.
Hey, I'm the same way. Like,
I gotta be lady too titty.
Yeah, you do.
Like the only.
You can give him a little bit.
Yeah, I ain't got nothing to say, man.
You're right. You gotta be a little something.
Oh, man.
The high and drunk of me might be like, what? Yeah.
I got something to say.
You say, I
said. Bust it.
Right. You got the juice there you go.
Hey.
Right.
Anybody seen the juice?
You have the juice. You have the juice.
Oh, my bad. I apologize.
Has anybody seen the juice?
That's why we got the producer.
Hey. Hey now, producer.
Hear me?
Ow.
I ain't with the owl. Sleep naked or clothed?
You say what?
You sleep naked or clothed?
Naked with my boo boo.
Naked.
Bucky naked.
Both, actually. I do both.
I sleep. I'm not good sleeping naked. I gotta sleep in my underoos and my wife beat at least.
I'm free as a bird.
Yeah, I can do both, man. I literally do both.
At home, like, I sleep in clothes, but I'm with him. At his house, I'm yeah, right. Naked. Bucky naked. You don't need no clothes. Right. Easy.
Like, man, you might as well take them clothes and lock them in the door.
That's right.
You ain't gonna need them.
Right.
You ain't gonna need them.
Fold it on up right there. Put it right there. And just go to bed.
Hit with the prince. Hey, don't touch that phone. You don't need it? We got all night. Yeah. Don't need touch. Oh, so right now he's playing Jodeci. Come and talk to me. Like, he just switched it up.
Oh, that's my song.
This is a good song, but now he's playing Freaky You. This is Freaky You.
This is song.
I wanna freak you.
I think it's for mine because I don't have my phone. Oh, she about to give us a show.
American Idol. Shit, hello.
She is.
Don't let me hold you.
Here comes.
Ain't that long.
Every time I close my eyes,
hey.
I wake up feeling so horny.
Yeah.
I can get you out of my mind.
What?
Sexy, you be all I see.
Hey,
I would give anything
just to make you understand me.
I don't give a damn about nothing else.
Freaky you is I
need
your body.
She dance like just the girls on the video too.
You don't see your ass down. What kind of show is this?
I couldn't go too far.
Yeah, you don't need.
I was restricted.
Good. You need some restriction.
I don't need any restriction.
What are your four pillars of a successful relationship? So, what are the four things? What? Wait. Damn.
What's wrong with you? You tongue-tied.
So my first question is, what do you notice first about a person? These are mine. Like, before you get to know their personality, all that goofy shit, what's important? So I have four T's. What's my four T's?
Here we go.
Teeth, right. Tits, tats, thighs. So four T's.
Ooh, I like that. Especially the thigh part is so now underrated, but it's like celebrated. For real. Like, seriously.
Right.
Oh, it's on point.
Right.
Right. And they're not. And here, not only they thick thighs. They thick. They not tits. Tats.
Tits and thighs.
The other one, baby, we got
to
be closing hers.
Oh,
love. She got some thick thighs, and they're not thunder thighs. You're the... Right. Like, babe. You just saw kissed by Athena herself. Like,
babe. Them some good ones. I like them.
Oh, the producer on. She is on. Right there. What I noticed first about a woman. What I noticed first. Of course, her face. Yes. I don't got the T-shirt. No. I'm sorry, brother. Or anything that.
It's been a long time to get here, brother. Then my reset.
Hey, I feel you, brother. I feel you.
I can know myself to know.
Well, thing is, smile is one thing I do. Where her face, at first, her face as well as her smile.
Okay.
Because I know a lot of girls who cute. Their smile is like, not even just the grill could be fucked up too, but the smile is just ugly. Like, yeah, you can't do that, you know? Like, I'm not trying to do the things. I can't do it. Like,
You won't believe this.
Oh, shit.
Right. While I'm online shit swiping, if she don't smile in her pictures, she got bad teeth. I look through all these pictures, I don't see not a smile or a body shot. That's an easy laugh. You not finna get me.
Well, I don't smile or take body shots, so what?
If I don't see your teeth in a profile, you got an 8-9 pictures on that motherfucker?
And I don't smile. I don't smile. Ask
me to send them
right.
A full body picture
of me
I want.
Right. Well, I don't do full body.
No, okay.
It's better if you just see it.
For yourself. Boom, there you go.
True.
3D.
Okay.
The picture ain't gonna do justice for all of
there you
okay.
go.
On there the flip go. Side, okay. I answered my question. On the flip side, Miss Producer, our lovely co-host for tonight. It's a flip side.
Like birthday cake.
So if you're talking to a dude, you saw a picture of his face, but you've never seen a body pic.
I don't ever ask dudes to send me a full picture of them. I get that a lot. I'd be like, babe, just meet me. Where you
want to
meet me?
Where you want to meet me?
I'm not afraid to meet. Where you
want to meet? Oh, but you could be afraid of him. Or he looking like I'm gonna say fat Albert. That's just I ain't saying body shaming, but you know, what if he's like, you know,
he's a dirtbag.
You know what I mean? What if he like a twink?
He's a dirtbag. That's what I said.
What you say.
Yeah, what if he like, you know what I'm saying, a twink away from being like,
but see, oh, when a person asks you for a full body picture, that's automatically them answering. Because if my face caught you enough.
No, you know what? She's right. I'm not saying that you are. I'm not saying.
If my face caught you enough, then now you're worried about what my body
is. Right. So that is kind of.
So I guess definitely being a superficial
person. Well, no, maybe it honestly could be like, you know what, like, damn, like, she has a cute face in it, but I don't know if.
I don't know what the fuck. I know my four T's are. I can't see all my T's from a face. I got four T's I look for. And if I can't see my T's.
But that's all, again, but.
Perfect. I love
them. I need to see my T's. That's all.
But that's like, the end of the day. Like, but in person, you see someone who, like, has a handsome gentleman. Right. Everything, you know, cute face and everything all to you, but his body's like.
But you know what? You can meet somebody that's very attractive, and you have a conversation with them, and you're like, you are trash.
Yeah. Yes, that conversation is a deal breaker.
It is.
The conversation is a deal breaker.
Yeah. And I have
If you don't have any conversation, it's a deal breaker.
But the conversation was trash.
From what I was told to by from an older lady, she was telling like how by an older lady, she was just telling me not like that. Like, all right, for women, it's all about, you know, her smile as well as her, you know, like keeping it, your attention. And for dudes, they need to be able to converse with you. If they don't know what to say to you or like basically, you know what I'm saying, get to know you or try to get to know you and everything, you know, like you said, trash. And for females, you know, they cute faces like, you know, but they have nothing to add themselves.
Right. And everything. Most men are not really worried about that because they like
the it's well, that's the thing. Well, that's the thing for women. Right. Y'all notice our shoes, yes, clothes up, you know what I'm saying?
Yes.
I wear Birkenstocks and Crocs.
You notice guys from the ground
look at my feet. They comfortable.
And for females, I mean, for us, we are looking from the sky down. Right. But sometimes we will, we won't skip. Please, the face, cute. Tears, like we said,
but some
yes,
dudes will skip the ass, and get somebody just because she got a nice ass.
That's
but,
it.
But true.
That's
but
true.
But those
and, and then be saying, "Oh, she is bad. She bad." I'm like, "Where she bad at?"
Oh yeah, she bad. She bad looking. Like yeah, but that's the thing, she you know. Like but it, again, this is that usually happens. I won't say no, it usually happens because that happen every damn day. Whether in a club, a grocery store. Yeah, I'll give you that. I'll give you that. Some men are like that.
As soon as she walk by and her ass is jiggling, she ain't got no drawers on, you like, you see that? Hey, dog, you can't even buy whatever it was you was in the store buying. You busy looking at her ass jiggling down the aisle.
I mean,
she look like Skeletor. Like, you woke up with her the next day, you're like, oh my God. Like, hey,
how
you doing?
Not Skeletor.
It's a Skeletor.
Skeletor. I used to love. But, you know what I'm saying?
A bag of balls.
Hey.
I don't know.
HC Lee, but that's
I have a very high moral standard, so I will never let a piece
it.
Of ass.
I cannot believe it.
I do. I
look at ass. I'm not gonna lie. I notice a lady's backside, the caboose, as well as her face. You know what I'm saying? And then you know what I'm saying? But I also look at the face too. Like, okay, that's cool. Let's see how the hair work. Not like that.
I was like,
talking about the brain, her vocabulary, the way
that
she
mouth
speaks.
Do though.
Right. But that's the thing. Hey, you know what I'm saying? Is she a wild one or she brings herself, you know, conducts herself with class and everything? But
I like vixens.
Well, no. That's what I'm saying. I'm not saying that you couldn't and everything, but you can tell who, when I say wild, like, I don't get it. Because.
You just don't want to.
No. Trust me, I've been around ghetto. Exactly. Because with ghetto is ghetto is the way you look, as well as you act. You act
the way that you carry yourself.
Yeah. But what dude is going to talk to? This is Isley Brothers Between the Sheets. Yeah, and they do. Come on, baby. Let's make love. Hey, girl, ain't no mystery. Mm-hmm.
Hey, man, I'm gonna tell y'all a secret. The reason I chose.
Okay, you can keep that playing a little bit low. You can let that play as you speak. Keep it low. I mean, like, you keep teasing us throughout the whole night. You know what I'm saying? Soon, I'm gonna say something, and you're gonna say, you know, play that Freak Me, Baby. And I'm like, all right, okay. That's what I'm saying. Then you go to another subject. So the president was coming out down street. Like, you some bitch.
So what were you getting ready to say?
I forgot. I'm going to tell y'all a secret. I forgot, man.
You said the only reason why you did what? Something.
I'm going to tell y'all a secret. I forgot the secret's going to be.
Oh, okay.
And he threw me off and tell me to play the bed, the lay down music.
Come on, baby. Let's make love.
Okay. Oh, the question was, okay. Everybody answer their questions? Mm-hmm.
Producer, queen. Okay.
All right. Next one. So I said, what are the four pillars of a successful relationship? As example, I'm gonna go first.
Okay.
So it's communication.
Yes. Uh-huh. Definitely.
Trust.
Uh-huh.
Sex.
Uh-huh.
Flexibility. Flexibility means in thought. Like, we shouldn't be thinking the same way at here we was right. going forward. You got to be flexible.
Right.
Be committed to your goals, but flexible with your methods.
Right. Okay.
Everything don't fit every situation. Okay. Some people be like, nah, this is what worked here, it'll work again. Nah, nigga.
Right.
You got to do some different shit now.
Yeah.
So those are my four.
Okay. So I would say communication, trust. I would say honesty.
Well, yeah, same as trust.
Okay. Yeah, you gotta be honest with trust.
Yeah.
Okay. Same thing. Communication, mm-hmm. honesty. I need some spontaneity.
Fluidity. Can't be stagnant.
Okay, there you go. It's not stagnant.
Like the words.
And
don't
I
you?
Need a man books, girl. With drive.
Ambition.
A man
with ambition and a woman with vision.
Yes.
Or it could be vice versa.
It could be vice versa. But
yeah. You can't be a happy 9-to-5 worker. That's how it works, nigga.
Yeah. Right.
We gotta figure out how to make some shit do
exactly.
something.
Exactly. Exactly.
Right. Yeah.
So this is for work or relationships?
Relationships.
Oh, is it?
Like right. your job, nigga.
Yeah.
Hey. you need some more in your cup?
Sure.
Wow. So,
who plays his knee?
I guess I'll
you can stand in front of the camera.
I guess I can tell you my.
Stand in front of the camera, Nicole.
No. Let that play, babe. Let that play. So,
do you mind?
I wouldn't mind having a female who was honest with me. Because, girl, I'll be honest with you. I wouldn't mind. Have a lady who's loving from our questions earlier and everything. Yes. Who's loving? I never have this way about this woman.
Am I before?
Because she not only comes to me and everything, but then I'm sorry. All right, so yeah,
she comes to me, comes on me.
Hey.
Bars, baby.
It happens.
Bars.
So, trust. Trust is one thing, just like both of you guys said, as well as our producer. Yes, trust is it's probably like the number one thing. All right, mm-hmm. seriously, because mm-hmm. the last thing anybody want to do is, you know, of course.
Stress.
Right. Well, you know what I'm saying? As soon as that person leaves the house, I wonder where he going. Oh, where's she going?
Who's
she
talking to? Relationship is over. Yeah. Then when you lose trust, it's over. You might as well just start over.
It's a wrap, right? It's a wrap.
You don't talk close to that goddamn mic.
You said what?
You don't talk close to that mic.
Come
see,
to the mic.
See how I sound?
I keep forgetting. I'm sorry.
So yes, trust, communication.
Too long, nigga. Trust communication.
I'm thinking communication
and trust. That's what he's
saying. I'm thinking about more and everything. I'm thinking about more. You with the person. Of course, you gotta be a lot. Gotta have the love. Gotta have love.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
And everything. And damn, wow, it's just, she is.
It's the cognac kicking in.
Yeah,
niggas,
I see.
Yeah, the niggas coming out.
You know what I'm saying?
The niggas is coming out.
They'll do sad.
The niggas is coming out.
The doors.
Asian shit. Olive oil.
They'll do sad.
The motherfucking drunk ass quiche over here.
Drunk, right. Aisha. Oh, yeah.
Wait.
He still
could trust and communication.
No, I said love too, but
we got three.
You just went on a whole nother level. I'm like,
you moving titties and ass over here to my right, man.
I was focused on the question.
I'm trying to keep
her beautiful loins.
I'm looking at you, but looking over there.
Keep
going, man.
This radio, you could have been like, oh, lace my head.
I'm not saying too much.
Man, I want to say individuality, but in a way, like, it's the same thing because you got to be able to be, you know what I'm saying, together, as well as like, all right, look,
and don't go crazy on her.
You don't want her to lose herself in you.
Yeah. As well as keep the relationship going, because if you guys remember, you guys just together and you always by each other, mm-hmm. you're gonna drive yourself crazy. I don't care, even mm-hmm. when you're married.
Right.
You still need like, yo, babe, here, hey. Like you don't get pressed time. Like, yo, like here, babe, here,
yeah.
babe, here.
Yeah.
Here's,
yeah.
It's $200.
Mm-hmm.
Go get your crazy friend. Y'all right. have a good night.
Right. It's the
and
life.
If she trusts you, she knows it, like, all right, you know what? I can understand. I see what he's talking about. I need my knife for my girl, so right. I can reset myself, right. and he probably do the same mm-hmm. thing.
Exactly.
And
exactly.
All that. As long as
there's go to brunch. Get you good brunch in. Come to the house with that. What's up?
Something, yeah. right. You know what I'm saying?
Saucy.
Exactly. Yes,
yeah.
you gotta have space. You have your space, your individuality right. to do stuff.
Because yes.
though you guys are together all the time, you still have like, you know,
you have to. Yeah. You can't lose yourself in your partner.
Yep.
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah.
Yep. Yeah. Do not.
Right.
So you,
this shit you do, I ain't want to do. I don't watch this stupid shit. Right. You enjoy it.
Right.
I'm gonna go do what the fuck I'm gonna do in the other room, right. whatever. Like shit, I like. I don't need you to watch it with me.
Right.
You got certain things that you like to do, but you know you got that one homegirl that you can do all
this.
Right. But that one home. Right. But that's that one. You don't need two or three, because I know the other two badass.
Well, no, hey. You have to have trust in the woman that you with and know.
True, but still.
Like to hang around. All my friends feel a purpose in my life. All my friends are totally different. If I was to put all my friends in a room together, they probably wouldn't even like each other. They all serve a purpose for me,
mm-hmm.
not for you.
True.
They serve a purpose for me.
Uh-huh.
For me to get the fulfillment that I need from those individuals. Serve your purpose for me, for what I need from you, and that's what people have to understand.
Yeah, but
you have to accept everybody in a certain situation, because everybody serves their purpose in their person's life.
Absolutely, it's friends that wouldn't be friends if I wasn't friends with them.
True. Yes. Oh yeah, but
like,
remember,
it's certain people that can knock you back on your step that you need to be on.
Knock you off.
You
yeah.
got other friends that'll be that. Girl, come on, let's go bust this window sign.
Yeah. Oh, she. You know like, yeah, she, so they also have a purpose.
Everybody has their purpose.
Right.
For you know the part that they play in your life.
Yeah.
Right.
So that's even with your mate or your spouse. That person feels a fulfillment that your friends can't feel. Or mm-hmm. your family came.
Like
everybody play their part. That's like being a team player.
True.
You got your coach. You need some more. You got good. Your everybody.
I'm good.
Somebody got to be the star on the team, and somebody got and everybody else got to support that.
Follow lead. Yeah, there's a leader. There's always a leader, and some followers.
That's how
relationship
work as well.
Yeah.
All play a purpose on this, and if we can't be a team, the team ain't gonna make it.
Team will make the dream work.
Hey, exactly.
Be a team, so it ain't no iron team. It's just like if you play any sport in life, it's the same thing. We are a team. So communication, loyalty, empathy, trust, all of that. God, if you ain't loyal to me, I can't trust you.
Basically, saying, if there's no trust, there's nothing. Basically.
Loyal.
Well, but that.
I got friends that I trust, but I know they ain't loyal.
Mm-hmm.
I trust them.
I know what you're good for.
That's what you're saying. I'm so saying because in a way, it's almost a
different thing. And loyalty is definitely over trust. If you loyal to me, there's some stuff I may can't trust you, and I know that.
Yeah.
But wouldn't that be the
same? I know I can't trust you with my money. I know I can't trust you with my man. But anything else, I know you're loyal.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm just saying, because isn't that like somewhat the, isn't that somewhat, it's somewhat the same thing? Because I have not met like someone who is who's loyal but he's not trustworthy.
It's a little different, because say you got that uncle that's a crackhead. You know that you can't trust him around your money, and you know you can't trust him around your dough.
But you know he's.
But you know if you need him. Lord.
Oh, right. I get that.
It's a difference.
I get that. Yes.
Difference.
Yes.
It's a big difference.
You're right, Queen.
Yes.
You're right.
I know.
You want this shirt? I can sit.
Right.
Good job.
Right.
I will sit right.
Ladies and gentlemen,
right.
Miss Producer. Miss Producer.
No, don't let me hold you back. What's mine is yours.
She just got to be me. Boo, 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 boo. Hey, she's doing a thing. She's doing a thing. But she's right.
You give us a four.
I did.
Give me all four in unison.
All right. Trust, communication. We said space and love. Mm-hmm. There's no love, there's nothing.
Yeah. Very beautiful. Appreciate it. Wow. Very beautiful collection of beautiful things. Beautiful. Okay. Very beautiful. Very beautiful.
As well as your communication, loyal, sex.
Let's cheat off my homework. Yeah, life is long but a short. Yeah. Right. But enjoy while you got it.
Yes.
That's right. I'm with the free thought and not hold on to whatever. Mm-hmm. Enjoy life.
You know what I love doing? Firing motherfuckers. I love moving on. Oh, I got to move on. But bye. Like people, some people hold on to motherfuckers. I don't hold on to
shit. Yeah, longer than what they're supposed to. Yeah. That
season
makes
reason.
Bad.
But yeah, exactly. But that's that. But that's
season, reason, lifetimes, man.
Yes, yeah.
And people don't believe in that.
No, it's the truth. Oh man, you're lying. Like, you know what? You are exactly for a season, like you said, or as well as the lesson. Like, all right, you know what? Like, I appreciate dating you because now I know what I want in a woman. You know, as long as you're honest with yourself too. Like, all right, not like okay, you did. If you know you did your best to preserve this relationship and help it. Like, all right, I know what I need. But sometimes, again, you probably got to work on yourself, too.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
No, you're right,
because people say, well, I've been knowing this person for 20 years. This person, this is my best friend.
No, they must be a psychopath murderer.
The first 20 years you've known them. Now it's time for somebody else to fulfill.
Or they do it because other people expect them to. Because of the
like peer pressure?
Yeah, because of the length they've been together. So other people may expect them to go ahead and be with that person because they've been together for a certain amount of time. Right. Right. And sometimes people are supposed to just parent. And that's why I think a lot of relationships don't last when it's kids involved, because sometimes you're just supposed to be a parent. So when you try to force something else, like be in a relationship, it never works because you're only supposed to parent that child.
True. I get that, but
person wasn't supposed to be your
man. I just want to say, like, well, if that's the case, these guys shouldn't even, like, procreate it. You just, you know.
I mean, it could have started off like that. It could have started off like that, but sometimes, I'm saying, when you meet somebody and you know how some things go fast,
well,
and the baby come up, and the baby is involved, okay? So, you really don't know if you were supposed to be in a relationship at all, but this baby is involved now. So I think don't try to make a relationship, just parent the kid. You know what I mean?
But
just
no.
It's such annoying that I'm not even going to say that because you have children that are born and married families and they're supposed to be with their parents for 20 years. Where the mom and dad probably dated as high school sweethearts, went to college together, got their careers, just started a family once they started working, you know, in the fields that they wanted to work in. But people do grow apart. And what may work 20 years ago or 15 years ago, or what you may need it in your life at that time, you may not need 20 years later. The person that I am now is definitely not the person I was 20 years ago.
Right.
So the things that I look for in a mate 20 years ago, I definitely don't look for now. So that's just come with growth and maturity.
Well, I don't have expectations.
That I loved then, that I didn't love them then. It just means that even if
you enjoy their company
in my life now, we're on two different pages and our ships just have sailed in different directions.
Yeah. But that's the thing. As long as it's all about the parenting part and everything.
Right.
And so, but both parents need to be true to themselves, as in like, all right, there is nothing here. Like that's what it is.
Right, right.
But it could be it. But the thing is, here's the funny part. I'm pretty sure you guys heard it and seen it. One, if not both, can't come together because of ego.
Yeah.
Well, pride. Well, pride same thing. So it is. It's just pride.
Right.
They can't, that as well as communication. Like, you know what? Pride. But no. That's it. What it is? Pride. Because if there's pride, there is no communication.
Right.
Correct.
All right. Exactly. If I can't come to you, we got a kid and we broke up down here, blah, 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 blah. and like you always want, like, hey, can you watch Junior tonight? I have something, you know, something to do tonight. Me knowing, I'm just saying, me knowing, all right, it's a Friday night. She ain't gonna know with her motherfucking friends. They all, no, so I know she gonna see, she gonna see, but
that I have with that.
But I'm saying, this is what I'm saying.
How can you babysit your own child?
Well, that's okay. If okay, what if it, it's that is the one all right? Thing that I give you that, but this, but thing is,
this is now I'm talking to a man. Do you have any children?
I have two.
Okay, so I'm speaking to you, but you don't have it.
Hell no, I'm outside, baby.
I got
this
little
right.
Running right through me. That's
go
ahead, girl.
We were in a relationship.
Do you want one of these microphones? I'm just sitting here listening to you talk. You might as well have one of these microphones.
With one of my friends. And you didn't have anything to do for the weekend. I'm not going to come to you and say, hey, can you watch Junior and Caitlin tonight while I go hang out with you?
Got him cognac out here.
No, I'm going to tell you that tonight, if you don't have anything planned, this is what I have planned. And I'm going to go about my business.
And that's exactly. That's why,
at the end of the day, they are both our children. And when you have things to do, I'm pretty sure you're not coming to me saying, hey, honey, what do you have planned today?
Well, that's the thing. That's what I'm talking about.
Podcast.
Oh shit! But bring me into this.
Okay, but I'm gonna say, but that's the thing though. That's only
we're both adults, and this is a household, and this is not a chore for anybody.
If both parents are in the house, which and we, I guess I was thinking in aspect if they're not, and this is your night to have your son or daughter, our kid. Let's just say that our kid, and. You don't, of course, like I say, if you don't know if I'm not doing anything, yes, hey, can you watch Junior?
Well, but, see, the thing is, I shouldn't be, if it's not your weekend, I shouldn't be asking you of any of your time.
No, anyway. True, but maybe something came up and you're like, all right, oh, I did promise it on this day and everything. Hey, Antonio, can you watch Junior tonight? I'm like, oh, if there's none there and I, of course, always want to see my kid, yeah, go ahead. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I'll probably casually, hey, what you doing?
All right. Hey, kid talk. This segment's over. Hey, guys. Right,
exactly.
Can I be on my show? I won't be included.
They took you off the show.
I pulled out.
Right.
Oh, I find women that don't need me to pull out no more. Okay. I did my part.
Right.
I did my part. I'm 36 year old, no children. I did my part. I've been responsible all my life.
All your life.
I tried to throw it away a couple times, but that was early 20s. I tried, buddy. Yeah, you're right. That's why I made my podcast. So I had a conversation I could be included in.
Well, you brought up the question.
I didn't go that far, though. We got the kids and trying to figure out who can watch what. That's, whoa, I don't know what this means. This
real quick.
Sorry.
Just being hey, baby, can you watch the kids today? I ain't gonna lie.
I'm the nigga I want her to come see. Look. Watch your goddamn kids.
She's coming to see me.
They trying to come see you.
You get away with mine. Drop this nigga off. Let's go. Hey. I'm already outside. What we doing?
I watch the kids, but can I borrow $50?
Absolutely. Here's 75, my nigga. Here's 75, my guy.
Hey, good looking out, my dude. Good looking out.
Because you're going to pay for a lady, no why. Hey,
you're a rare one.
Absolutely. Absolutely. That's part of my, I budget that into my budget for single mothers.
Hey, baby, you got $75, baby.
Yeah, next time it'll be 100, but what you do to that mouth tonight, it'll go up for you.
Goodness.
Wait.
Tell me you love me. Show me how much you care.
Wait.
I'm definitely.
Not worth that 75.
I'm definitely taking notes. Oh yeah. I know what it looks like. I know what caring looks like. I know what it feels like.
Come here, girl, and see what that mouth do.
Oh Lord.
Okay. All right. Okay. Okay, we can get the fuck about it.
You juicy mouthed.
Juicy mouthed. That's a hell of a thing to say. Juicy mouthed. All right. How would you describe the dating market and how do you fit in it?
Ooh. Ew, the dating market.
If you don't get into that fucking microphone, I swear for God.
Sorry.
See, you should have had that mouth.
I would say the dating market has sucked donkeys.
Suck all the donkeys.
Until recently, I would say some months ago. And then I am back on the dating thing again because it's been awesome. But Before then, it was like, it was.
I hope you suck. Nigga, it was COVID. It supposed to be bad in 2020.
It was bad before then.
So you're dating someone, so that's what makes it bad.
Exactly. I'm dating someone, so that makes it all the better. I don't. Well, hey, I just answered the question.
I just asked you what's the mark and how you fit in.
It's
better.
It's really hard.
Because you got somebody.
Yeah, it's better because I got. But the dating thing is really hard.
Only if you make it hard.
No, you think so?
Yeah, I think exactly. What
believe what they show you. That's okay. It.
You're right.
And know what you want. Know what you want to do.
And you're right. And you're right. And you're right. So right. And you're right. And you're right. So so that's what I don't have expectations of people anymore. So it's been great for me.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Not to have expectations of people because it's not fair to them or you. Mm-hmm. But really, it's really not fair to them. It's not fair to them because you ghost them because you have these expectations of them.
Or have nothing at all.
Hey, you do like the Mary J.
I can't stand him.
You like the Mary J.
You know what I mean? I cannot.
I love you, some Mary. I watched the 20 My Life on Amazon. I cried.
I didn't watch it.
I was drunk and crying.
You was drunk and crying.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely, it's beautiful. I feel like Mary J. Like it's a very reflective conversation she had. It was good.
Was it
good? I figured it would be.
Yeah, I haven't watched.
Get you a good bottle of wine, some good weed.
And
you know
good.
What I'm saying? It's one of those. Yeah, it's one of those. Yeah.
I mean, she going through her life. Yeah. I mean.
We need to watch together, friend. We need to watch together.
That's I'm trying to watch it with somebody's mother so we can, you know, make sure they feel better.
Oh, I ain't going to do it.
But that's the kind of person I am. Yeah. It's definitely going to, we're going to feel some type of way, put some Mary J. on and hit the right track. We've been had some cracks. If we crack these backs out here. I own the couch.
Hit some of my cracks. I'm going to
look right now. In the motherfucking knee boots.
Right.
For all day, turn to it like, man, I ain't going to never do like Ken did. Ever. Your money's your money.
Fuck KC. Fuck Ken dude.
Right, hear me?
Stop fucking niggas with the name of K on there. That's right. See the trend. Right. Call you a Craig or a motherfucking M or something. K is fucking your
right. Okay.
What was the question again? Everybody know?
How's the dating market and how do I fit? Let's see. How's the dating market? I guess it's okay. I've gone on a few lately and everything, but I do see a lot of, man, like a lot of females looking the same damn way. And
that's
the same dude. And the same dudes. They look for the same dude, all dressed the motherfucking same. So I guess I'm like you. I'm like, oh, looking for some grown folks. How y'all doing tonight?
I look.
But
mothers only over here. You got no kids. You ain't talked to. Ew, you got no kids.
There is like
your pussy is trash. If you ain't had no nigga busting, you give you baby, your pussy's garbage.
Garbage.
Same. Oh, single mothers only over here. Middle school and above. Kid, there's some new ones out here looking bad. A lot of babies happening in 2020. I see y'all another baby shower. Y'all got COVID outside.
There's some pandemic babies. Some COVID babies.
I was just hating.
I mean, you can't do nothing else. Like,
you couldn't do nothing.
Can't go to the movies. Can't do
it. Can't do nothing else.
Can't do nothing. Like, oh man, what the fuck?
Here we are.
Sure, let's go.
Here we are again. Let's burn 20 minutes.
Here you go.
Right. Like, damn, girl.
I want some more creative ways.
Back to this balcony again.
No, not the balcony again.
That's the best thing though. Been over the balcony instead of
give me a great date story and a bad date story. Give me a horror story and a joy of dating. And give me a good date and a bad date. We know RJ's already. Shit. Better bring that shit up no more. Second goddamn week.
You know, a good date. I'm not with her anymore. Oh, well, we were never really together. We just went on a couple of dates and everything. But I thought it was probably one of the best dates I've been on. And that was, I took her to a bowling alley that had a putt-putt golf.
Mm-hmm.
And a reason why I did, I was like, I was watching Karate Kid a couple of days earlier. And if the original, they
wax
went to
home.
A
yeah,
uh huh. But they went to a member.
They did go
to a, like a carnival
golf thingy. Yeah.
it was almost like the same shit we did and everything, minus the 80s music and everything. Play golf and everything, talk and everything, all that, bowled a little bit. Did we go to the Ben Cages? No, but we played a lot of video games. And I was like, and she was totally cool with it. Like, yeah. Like, come on now. Like, yeah. can't beat that and everything. But what made it better, because the second date, I kind of said nothing. Well, no, I probably did something. But the second date was good because I let her plan.
Today.
Yeah. I want to see how you live. How what's going on in your mind? Like, what do you like?
Where do you find joy?
Right.
Okay. Sounds fair.
Right.
You got, what's your, give me a bad one. What's the bad date?
Bad date. Probably, she wanted to go out, and mm-hmm. me personally, I was like, okay, that's fine, you know, I didn't really want to and everything. Went to the movies, and went to dinner, paid for them, not a big deal, but I thought, like, okay, there really was connection. She wanted to go to, like, two other places, as well as want me to pay for everything. Like, oh, okay. You want me to be a young Marcus. Straight.
Whoa,
you
know, and, whoa,
you want to be
whoa.
Young Marcus. No, I'm not sure. But no, like, no. I mean, because you said you simp back in the day. Yeah, again, yeah, yeah. Young, not current. I hate current. 80s now. And you want me to pay for everything? I was like, no. I'm like, nah, bro. I'm like, and she tried to berate me.
No.
In front of everybody.
Oh, no.
Right. And though I was quiet, she did not know about my background, which is I'm from the projects on the street. And though I am quiet, I don't give a fuck if male or female, I will let you have it. Though I'm in the projects, masculine, I was raised by my mother, my two sisters, no, three sisters, one from my father's side. Cousins, aunts, always throwing some of hers in my ear. Like, no, what? Yeah. You can walk away from, but don't let them berate you as well as swing on you and do nothing back. Uh-huh. You don't hit them, but put them down.
Shove the shit out your ass.
Right. Don't hit them, but, you know what I'm saying, let them know that you are
stump your goddamn toes.
But so, you know what? Sometimes that's not a bad idea. Before, like, you make it like you better, like, slap them, and then as they went, that's right, then they went to back to protect themselves, stump that big ass, that big right, ass
hit
toe.
Hit that big toe. Break the whole nail off that bitch.
Big toe. Right, hit that big toe.
Now get your feet done.
Or the ring, because either way, they're going to jump back. Like, you motherfucker. Your mama ain't shit. Mm. Da 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 da. Like, yeah, but yeah,
I'm not talking to me nice. That's so I got it on my shirt.
Disgusting.
I'm just saying, talk to me nice. What's up? What's your bad and bad? What's your good and bad? We got enough time for this?
No.
Nope.
The silent
make
treatment.
It short.
Okay.
Just give us a short version.
What's my first, one of my good dates I've had in a long time?
I wish you had a little microphone.
Oh, shit. I keep forgetting.
Wow, what's this day part? Like, I'm just sitting having a drink. Mine and my dammy, and it's always day. Like, well, let me guess. Bird of a feather flock to a vagina.
No, I went to the gun range. That was really fun.
I was like, that sounds good.
I'm taking some women to the gun range.
Yeah, I went to the gun range.
You really want to see a woman crazy? Take it to a gun range.
Yeah.
Yes.
She put it.
Yes.
She cocked and loaded.
I did. I cocked and loaded. I had a good.
Yeah.
I shot some shit up.
Yeah, I did too that night. Bang, 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 bang.
Were you okay, when you
like pops? Bang, 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 bang.
When you were shooting, were you like screaming like ah or anything like that?
Nah, I didn't do none of that. So you I had my eyes closed. And then I had
to Draco.
Okay, I reloaded.
That's what I was doing, but something like that. Yeah. Something like that.
Bang bang.
And I can't think of a really, really bad date.
Me neither. I don't think I've had a bad date.
Yeah, I don't think I've really had a bad date.
Might have been a follow up, but we
it
was a bad
date. It wasn't a follow up, but it wasn't a bad date. It was like, yeah. He tried, yeah, you know what I'm saying? But
food was good.
Right. I was hungry anyway. Right. I was hungry anyway. Something like that. But it was, I don't think I've had a bad date. But
I don't want to take over the show because he said,
no, man, go ahead. It's not my show. I'm here every week. What's up?
Speaking of dating and everything, just one question I want to know. Okay. Mike, what was I going to ask? If you had a bad, okay, not a bad date, just a meh kind of date. There's no attraction, no spark, no electricity, nothing. You guys got something common, but it's just no connection. Mm. Do you think it's okay? As Miss Producer, please feel free to jump in this too.
No, she will.
As well as my homie too.
Why did you ask her? You know she will.
I love the opinions, especially these women. I do too. Because I want to hear from them anyway.
Absolutely. But
my question is, if there's no connection at all and none of that, and check comes and everything, he asks for two separate bills. Would you get mad right that night? Or would you get mad right there? Or would you just, be okay with it?
I'd be okay.
Mm. Some women don't. Some,
you know why I would be okay?
No.
With it?
I'm going to say no.
I would be okay with it because now we have a mutual understanding.
No, F that.
This is it.
F See? That. No, this is forget
where is
that.
This is where
forget I'm... that because before you went on that date, he asked you out. There was.
I've had a bad date.
I mean, I understand that, but if that, I understand that, but I'm
no,
saying
no, no,
that,
no, no, no.
Not it, like that.
It won't be like that.
Not
no,
like that.
It just you're splitting the bill.
Right.
That's it. I would.
But you didn't know that at first, right?
Huh?
You didn't know that at first, right?
No, you didn't, but...
That's what I'm saying, and there's a problem with that. Because now I feel like he's in his emotions. If it wasn't...
But I would be cool with it.
Nah, right. I ain't gonna lie and say I'd be cool with that shit. I'm not gonna be cool with that.
I feel what you're saying. I'm not gonna be cool with that
because you took me out on a date, and just because I didn't say what you wanted to hear, then you gonna make me pay for my own food? No, I'm not... I would pay for my shit, but that'd be it.
Yeah,
that'd be it. I would pay for it, that would be it because then I think you on some BS. You know what I'm saying? That's some bull crap.
But the thing is, there's no connection. So why is he entitled? I'm not saying he's not entitled to keep half of his currency because. You didn't have a good time and everything. You know, I'm not saying it's not bad
because
but
you still have to follow through with the date. You still need to follow through with the date, and that's because if you know before then that you it's not anything there. But you still, as a man asking a woman out on a date, you need to follow through on that date, which means you're gonna pay for that date, but it won't be anything else after that. You know what I'm saying?
But isn't a date about emotions anyway? Like you're trying to get to know that person,
right?
You're
but you shouldn't put so many emotions.
Like you might lose, it. Might win on losing that stock.
Right, right. You know what I'm saying? It's
but the thing you
gotta invest your money.
Right.
Sometimes you get it back, sometimes you don't. That's a part of
it. But that's the thing.
Trade.
I feel it.
Women are stocks.
I was saying,
did you say women are stocks?
The situation was going to go a little bit.
Somebody heard it?
What?
I heard it.
So I was cool with the fact.
Hear what?
With the fact of me paying my way, you paying your way. Yeah, that may not have been the plan when we first left the house, but I can see that we're not seeing eye to eye.
Okay.
Like, we're not compatible in any kind of way. So it's just best as long as I don't have to Uber myself home. I'm cool with paying my way, you paying your way, and you dropping me off at home. I've been in a situation where I've been on a date with someone, and our second date, we went to the show, and we went out to eat afterwards, and it was a conversation that he brought up, and he asked a question that I guess I didn't get the answer. He wanted
to Not you.
And he was feeling some kind of way. But you asked me a question, you wanted me to be 100
right.
about it, and I gave you my 100.
You know, your answer, your true answer.
I could tell that his whole energy was starting to change. The first thing I said to him was, do I need to find a way?
Mm-hmm.
He was like, why did you say that? I said, I can tell. And right now, me not feeling
good.
I'm okay with it. Because I'm an adult, so I'm
going to
take care of me regardless.
I understand that too, though, but I feel like you're going to follow through with this date.
No,
and okay. pay for the rest this of this date. Thing.
I know me. If I'm in the presence of someone that I do not want to be in the presence of,
I'm still making
drop me off.
I feel so that's why. That's why you should.
I'm hungry.
So, okay, honestly, I like, but I'll.
Ma'am,
I'm sorry hungry. I ate all the cashews. Okay,
hey, you need to calm down. Nuts.
He did. And all right. He offered me done. Like,
and
one,
I went upstairs
and
didn't bring no nuts down. I'm sorry. I'm guilty too now. Damn.
Yes, and he didn't even offer us just a not.
All right, as close as that.
We just heard the song. Two wrongs don't make it right. And
two wrongs don't make it right.
I forgot to offer it nuts, and Jill got a yell at me like she crazy.
I love you too, love. I apologize too for not getting that. A heart is not a home, baby. A heart is not a home.
Come around so, again. I wish I knew this song.
Hey.
It doesn't feel like.
It's a house of love, and I learned.
And it don't it's a house.
You should turn the fucking Meg Thee Stallion on the Dales. Okay, all right. We can fuck about it. Okay. Closing thoughts, y'all. Closing thoughts and prayers.
Okay,
what? Go ahead. Give us a closing thought. Closing tabs out. You need to come back to you?
Yeah, come back to me.
I figure.
I believe something you say a lot, which I always really take to heart, and a lot of friends would tell me. Saying this as well as one of my mentors at work, man, live your authentic self.
Mm-hmm.
You know, seriously, like chase your dream. Mm-hmm. Like I work at this aerospace manufacturing company. Love it. I like working there, but I feel like I'm doing more.
Mm-hmm.
And that's why, you know, I'm trying to study to get these certificates to better myself so I can be in that 250 to 300, 400.
Hey, you deserve more than that. You worth more.
You know what I'm saying?
You can make more than that.
Oh yeah, I know. Right, you know what I'm saying? But you know,
that's a start.
You know, but gotta have a dream.
You want to be a high valued man?
Hey,
right,
Mr. Samuels.
You want to be a high valued man?
Hey,
you want
to
be a high
valued man? But my only problem is I have to be that. What do you say? To be that, can't handle kids or that bullshit, which is, I'm like, that's bullshit.
I can't stand.
But the thing is, I want to show my son, like, yo, you can persevere through
options.
Through bullshit.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Or in this case, setbacks. I'm not saying that, he is or what I did was, I need to, again, yes, I fell down. Now I pick myself up. But I'm not trying to pick myself up and just stand up. I'm going to climb this damn rope as I'm going up to be better. So,
I
appreciate it.
Yeah.
But have fun there. You know what I'm saying?
Yes, you will.
But do that and everything. Just be yourself as well as have fun too, man. Mm-hmm. Again, on the way. Life is already hard.
Yeah.
So why not smile and crack a joke on the way?
That's true.
Amen to that shit.
Amen to that shit.
Hey.
Amen to that shit.
Amen.
Amen. You ready?
Amen. I would say never.
The lip gloss is popping, girl.
Thank you. That
mouth looking moist. Like a moist mouth. House is like a home, baby. Woo!
Love is a house. Love is a house.
That mouth like a home right there singing.
Okay.
I'm sorry.
Chopping it
through. I'm sorry.
I would say everybody's not going to understand your calling and where you're going in life. So your vision, I want to say your vision is not for everybody to understand. So just keep going with your vision. You know what I'm saying? Keep going for what you think and what you know is good for you. And,
what's good for the goose?
It's good for the gander.
It's good for the gander.
Yeah.
Oh, Sheila. Oh,
why would you...
For baby. Trying to give it to
you. I put this rap shit on hold because I feel
like remix too.
They said I'd never be shit, but now I'm as real as it could.
Go, hey, baby. You know I love when she over 40, no throw babies. So, well, like her. I'm gonna buy her breakfast. Her little slip, her like little gown, her little night robe. Ooh, I say, yeah, hey, Mrs. Johnson.
Like, you know what, grown. Baby? I'm gonna go ahead. I'm gonna go ahead and get you these doctor shows.
I said, hey, baby, I'm looking at these Birkenstocks. You want to get these for me? Oh, I got you. Ooh, I got you too, girl. Get you something. What you need?
Like, you know what, man? I'm gonna go ahead and go to Starbucks for you, baby.
What you need me to do? I get your oil change.
Like, baby, you want me to change the brakes on your car? Nah. Go ahead, take my keys, baby. Let me rotate these ties.
Get your mission to safety done for you. Let's stay right there.
Let me rotate these ties, baby.
I know.
Vibing in the A with a bad little bitch. It was Jimmy and Cannon plus Rich. And the Uber with 5%
I got the best head in the world on.
Woo!
I be ready to put a lift on my dick and she swear.
So, baby. Let me stop. Let me get up out of here.
So, got this Epsom salt. Go ahead, soak it up.
I want to thank Cherise. I want to thank Antonio for coming down to Cognac Corner.
Black Pacino, baby.
Thanks for having me. Yeah.
I want to thank producer Nicole out there. Next time I got to buy a fourth mic so she
that's
can do
right.
our bigger table, so I got to do better.
Go, baby.
Right.
You got to get your life together.
I'm trying. I'm working on it. I'm trying to do something. I'm trying, guys. I promise. All right. Love can be the road that happens, but most times happens when you write your doorstep of love, because only happy people can be in love. One more time for people in the back.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Let me get the moisture out of my mouth.
There you go.
Juicy mouth.
I have an oversized tongue, my doctor said. And we're going to leave it there. Okay? Love can be the road to happiness, but most times, happiness leads you right to the doorstep of love, because only happy people can be in love. Bonus. Trust is lost in buckets, but gained in drops. So be careful who you fuck over.
Yeah.
Be careful.
Most definitely.
Because the pee going up, you can see them coming down.
That's right.
Talk to me nice.
That's right. Talk to me nice.
Trust is lost in buckets, but gained in drops. Love yourself. Love each other. And love is all we
in my deep with passion, it feel like she talking to me. She be telling me shit. Go ahead and spit on it.
Yes, sir.
Pull out my dick and she lick on it. I know she weak.
Face it. Owning a home today sucks. 12 different accounts to pay your bills. Trying to keep up with documents. Filing insurance claims. It's all a big hassle. Grease fires. Plumbing leaks. Toilet overflows. This and that and that and this. We can all use a little bit of help. So what's your home plan? Sign up for home plan today. And get a little bit of help managing your home. It's home management made simple. Sign up at joinhomeplan.com.